Welcome back to Lunar 2. Time to follow Lucia. And, you know, now plot important. Yeah, anyway. Again, when I first saw this area, I'm like, there has to be something that is plot important happen here. Maybe not in the form that I expected, but at the same time, I knew that there was something here. It's like, it has to be. It looks like, you know, when you play a lot of games and you're like, this is a boss room. Like, I didn't get the boss room vibe, just, you know, story vibe thing. You know what I mean. You know, it doesn't really look like a lake to me. The whole... it's too uniform. You know what I mean? Like, when you look at the water, it has one pattern. This really doesn't make me even think water. Oh. You know, Lucia is definitely an individual who knows how to get where she's going. No, I don't think she has. And I just love how Lamina covers her eyes. Like, everyone else just jumps off plainly, but Lamina is just like, oh god, no, this is gonna be terrible. You know, that little detail right at the end. I know, I get obsessed over little things like that. It's fine. Fifth Tower of Pentagulia. I have to say, it's a lot more imposing than the other four. Well, if you want to hide something, sometimes, you know, just hiding it in plain sight and, you know, throwing a tarp over it helps. Lucia, I don't think it's going to be that simple. I don't think it's going to be, you know, I'm inside, everything is done. No, I think it's going to be a little bit more complicated than that. Oh. Well, that's awkward. Does that do damage? No, it doesn't. Never felt anything this powerful. That's... actually, kind of impressive, considering her powers at the beginning of the game. I wonder what your name actually is. You know, we have the fake Alfina, but what is her real name? Keep the purity of this place from escaping into the world. That's bad, isn't it? Created by the very power that Alfina used for protection. That's... actually... like, I wouldn't... like, yeah, it's got its ironic thing, but, you know, from... a point of view of... you know, how to do it, that seems like the best option. Hi, Mari. Tub of lard. And Lun. Or should I say, you know, masked man. Or unmasked masked man, anyway. Oh, boy. Yeah, pretty much. I mean, we might be able to handle, I don't know how powerful Mari and, what's going on? The white dragon wings are shining? Oh! Yeah, that was a present from Nall. Galleon, you're a little bit late to the party. You know, now that we know Althina, well, we know for sure that this Althina is fake, Galleon's contempt towards her is just delicious.
Wait, Galleon.
So far.
Use what's left of your head. It is not necessary to roam the land chasing Lucia and her ragtag party of misfits. They will return to this very spot of their own free will. Lucia must return to this town to meet Althea and complete her mission.
Yes, so far, but I'm certain that Lucia will try to free the four dragons you have sealed to save Althina. She must...
Well then, you must work to strengthen the seal and make certain that she does not succeed. For the moment, I will just watch and relish the way she worms her way into the hearts of the humans that have foolishly befriended her. She is so misguided to even try to harness the power of humankind to complete her mission. But her attachment will be her undoing. Mark my words.
Zophar has a point. No matter what we do out in the world, we still need to return to that spot. That is where Lucia sensed Althina. We have to go back there. But now, you know, because of that, it's like, you know, because of, you know, this thing with Lucia's befriending of the humans and all of that, it's like, do I really want to continue on? Like, there's a little bit of doubt. Hey, Noel. Yeah. I don't think we want to face Mari, Bragan, Lun, the fake Althina, and Galleon. Yeah, no. No, that's not going to go well at all. You know, Ronfar, to be fair, like, I don't know how long the whole Althina cult thing has been going on to revive Zophar. As far as I can tell, you were an actual, well, you're a gambling, womanizing priest, but, you know, you're doing the whole real Althina thing. Just like Leo. Oh. So we can't even use the white dragon wings? Thank you, game! It's like about damn time. I wanted it, it's like it had to happen. So, wait, did... Like, okay, Nall is the white dragon, Ruby is the red dragon. When did her power get sealed, or has her power not activated yet, and the older, elder red dragon has their power sealed? That second one seems a little bit more likely, since, you know, Ruby is still pretty young. Oh. Figures. So yeah, that text box right there. I see you no longer have the boy or the goddess to protect you. This is the same Null from the last game. Like, this little text box, in addition to, you know, the earlier one of Null, you are the white dragon of Althena, blah, 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 blah. This text box I have been waiting for so long. It's like, just confirm it. Like, I really, really deeply, like, 90% sure that you are. But, game, please just confirm it. So, that's happened. So, perfect. The other interesting thing is Null has been doing this for a while. You know, doing the whole rescue kids thing. I did manage to crush your father. Was that Quark? Yeah, because Galleon killed Quark in the previous game, didn't he? If I'm remembering correctly, it has been a few years since I played the game, so... Oh. I think Null actually needs that. Galleon left with a... When did this happen? That's the only thing that... Much, much stronger than... Oh, no. Like, when did this happen? Did this happen before we met Null? Or, you know, in the meantime? I'm assuming before. Okay, so Ruby hasn't claimed our power yet. So that there's another... Red Dragon. You don't remember it because you were just a child. Oh! So Null is just... So apparently he can still turn into his... I'm assuming that this happened well before any of this happened, like the aura was taken. So Null can still transform between, you know, his flying cat form and his human form. Now the question is, he probably doesn't have his, full-sized, you know, normal body form, though. Hero's going to help her? Duh? I don't even, like, usually I would, like, try for the other answer, but there's no way I can just be like, no, yeah, I'm not doing it. I can't do that. But, you know, making that confirmation of, yeah, I'm going to help her, that there's still the whole bit of Lucia's foolishness of relying on the power of humankind. Like, what is that about? Is that important? She'll get it eventually, Null. Eventually. Yeah. Oh! Well, that's easy. This bet is the one that counts. That's... Ooh. And since everybody's issues, we have to go fight them anyway, it's like, yeah, of course everybody's going to stick together. Like, if we take care of, you know, Ronfar's issue first, Lamina's going to be there to help, because Ronfar would be like, yeah, I'm willing to help you with your issue with, you know, Tubby. And we'll use its power for good and- Finally! You know, Gene finally reached the answer of, I know how to do this. I don't like the fact that I know how to do it, but I'm going to use it, you know, for the good of people. Mega Grudge. Borgen. See, I'd forgotten his name. That's why I kept calling him Tubby. And she called him a turd. Lookout Squad Ensign Hawk. Really? Well, yeah, if he's carrying around the Dragon Aura, maybe he can tell. The White Dragon Cave. This ought to be a piece of cake. I would think so. I mean, Leo has been helping us, and not Leo has been helping us. And the only thing I'm really concerned about is, like, he has a lot of issues right now. Like, his entire world has been turned upside down recently. Like, I don't know what's going on in Leo's head, because, anyway. So Leo has the White Dragon Aura. He's parked right outside of Vayne, which is next door. Yeah, this should be cakewalk. I doubt the next three are going to be that easy. Like, Mari, Lun, and Borgen have the other three. I think Leo is going to be the easiest round. I mean, he is a friend of Ronfar's, and, well, the only thing is he has those issues. You know, his point of view of the world is in turmoil. Oh! It's literally right outside.
Hero, you must fight me. The Chosen. Their way is not right. I know it in my heart. However, I do not know how to escape from the web in which I become ensnared. And my options now are severely limited. I know good must prevail. Prove it now with your sword.
Oh. So he's come to accept, you know, that he's, you know, accepting reality. However, he still wants us to fight him. Now, he's not that tough, to be honest. This is very much character versus character. Leo has, you know, if you had...
I save this for you, infidel!
Hero fight like Ronfar normally, or Lumina or something, that's kind of what to expect. The only difference is Leo has a little bit more life. It seems like he has about 800-ish. But... this isn't that bad. It really isn't. Like, I'm gonna get through this and maybe use, like, one healing item. Like, legitimately, that's as much as I'm going to use.
Sample my goods.
Unfortunately, he does that. Which isn't really a big deal. My healing ring is pretty much taking care of the majority of the problem. The only thing that's really bad is getting hit by Flashblade. His physical abilities, but mostly Flashblade. He's just not that tough.
Dodge this.
But I think he only has that one item. And he used it pretty early, which is, you know, to his detriment. But to be fair, I have a lot more stuff than he does. I still should be fine if he decides to use Flashblade.
Dodge this.
You really shouldn't lose this fight. You shouldn't.
I save this for you, infidel.
Considering Leo is a little... not Leo. Hero is a little bit faster than Leo. This usually isn't a problem. Like, you're gonna use one healing knot. That's as far as it's gonna go.
Kneel and perish.
And he seems to favor magic attacks. Which... isn't really his forte, so... nah.
Dodge this!
And that's it. 5,000 experience, which is a really big reward considering how, you know, easy that is. I'll take it. Not to mention the White Dragon Aura, which we need to, you know, release the powers of Null. Yeah, actually, Leo, come with us. Seriously, you're no slouch. I mean, you're slower than Hero, but you definitely hit harder. Okay. Oh! You know, and the thing is, too, that this ties into the whole... You know, much earlier when Hero, at the end of the first disc, wanted to talk to Lucia, and he's like, no, Ruby, I want to stand at the helm. It's like, oh, he's actually getting to do it now. You know, granted, that was a little subterfuge on his part towards Ruby, but it's like, oh... Oh. I honestly think we're going to see Leo again. I really do. Yeah. I mean, he understands, you know, what's really going on. But there's that. He feels like a common criminal. He actually needs to come to terms with what he's actually done, you know, the fact that he was used. You know, there's a difference between accepting the reality and coming to terms with it. So yeah, we get to drive the Destiny. Which is a good thing. You know, the wildly unsafe speeds on land or in the water. And yeah, very much... We get to drive the Destiny, like this, actually just drive through the forest, that actually feels a little bit weird to be honest. Okay. And look how many areas we just skipped. We skipped, you know, that area, like, that glitching. Nah, just the one. Granted, there was a lot of, silver in that area, but that's fine. But yeah, it, no change in difference, it just goes. But anyway, next time, I don't know why they move so far, next time, we'll actually go to our goal, and head over to the White Dragon Cave, and, well, use the aura and free Null's powers. Until then, I like the fact that we can still explore the Destiny. You know, granted, we've already been through this area like 4 times, you know, gone through the ship, but at the same time, is there anybody else on this? Like, the crew. And the fact that we have a, you know, free Althina statue just roaming around. It looks like the crew is gone. To be fair, they probably followed Leo. Anyway, yes, until next time.